Across the country, hundreds of companies are helping reverse a long trend of sending American manufacturing jobs overseas.
They're doing what's known as reshoring. That's bringing production back home to cities across the U.S. instead of chasing cheap labor and other incentives in developing nations.
Over the last 4 years, about 100,000 jobs have returned to the U.S. That's according to the Reshoring Initiative, a nonprofit group based in Chicago. Many factors contribute to the U.S. regaining a competitive edge over countries like India, Japan, and China.
Chinese wages have been rising, expressed in U.S. dollars, at 15 to 18% per year for the last 15 years. Whereas in the U.S., it's stayed stationary.
Other reasons include delivery time, quality, and innovation.
Turns out you can't innovate the product very well if you don't manufacture the product.
Chesapeake Bay Candle Company opened its first domestic manufacturing facility in 2011.
We created over 80 jobs in the last 3 years.
Owner and CEO Mei Shi started the company back in 1994 in her Maryland basement.
We were so impatient waiting for molds to fill our candles with. We saw a lot of soup cans lying around the kitchen. We say, wow, these are great molds. So we just use them. The first set of samples were made with those molds.
Despite its U.S. origins, May opened her first factory overseas because of cheaper labor cost.
If you have a mold, you first finish it by pouring wax in it, and then you have to manipulate the texture so that it achieves a desired result. So each candle would be priced at $40 or $50, and it's not really going to be the market that can accept that.
The company grew quickly for about 10 years, until the 2005 recession blew in.
Consumers stopped purchasing as they used to in 2005 or before that. So our retail partners demanded a price reduction.
That change caused May to reevaluate her decision to do business from China. In the end, it made sense to bring a big part of her company's manufacturing back home. Reshoring, however, can be risky, and many attempts are unsuccessful. Some experts blame those results on the U.S. government.
On the one hand, there's the reshoring initiative, which is, like we've been talking about, this push to bring high-paying manufacturing jobs and activities back to the United States. At the same time, the U.S. government, since probably about 2008, has gotten really serious about enforcing U.S. regulations governing exports and international conduct. People are being encouraged to bring their manufacturing back here, but they don't realize that the cost of complying with these kinds of regulations and managing the risks of them can be quite substantial, so they work across purposes.
The opening of the Chesapeake Bay Candle Glen Burnie facility was delayed for 6 months because of the process of getting a permit.
They look at us as if we are a little bit crazy, but they say, we haven't given a license in 2 decades, but we think if you look at hospital code, school code, and a restaurant code, you're safe.
During the entire delay, they still had to pay for the facility and key staff members, although the doors remained closed. Eventually, the permits came through, and the Chesapeake Bay Candle Company became one of the success stories.
If we have not moved the manufacturing back, we wouldn't be growing like we were growing.
About 50% of the company's business currently comes from here in their Glen Burnie factory. But after adding a new production line, they have the capacity to triple that number in the future.
Word has been out that we have moved back. We have people knocking on our doors to say, can you produce for us? There are so many companies that we wouldn't dream of, you know, giving us an order easily because they require Made in USA.
And May has a message to the government as they encourage more companies to come home.
Do not become a business prevention if you are trying to be a business creation.
Caitlin Burke, CBN News, Glen Burnie, Maryland.